Hey, Bill Shockey here. Welcome to another edition of the 5-Minute Motivator. Welcome to an absolutely spectacular morning in Tamarindo, Costa Rica. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful weather here. Just a great place to be alive and to contemplate reality and to do some research into things that are important, I hope, to you. Hey, folks, please like, share, and comment on these 5-Minute Motivators. It would be very, very helpful to me. Your likes and your comments go a long way, but if you share this with your social media compatriots on whatever social media platform you're listening to this on and watching it, it would be fantastic. I do appreciate it. Thank you. I'd like to talk today about something called the praying mantis in the spider web. Now, let me give you the story, and then I'll put it into context. When I was a wee lad, and by wee lad, I mean like I was 6 or 7 years old, so this was somewhere in the mid-60s, yo. I was observing this spider in its spider web that had a praying mantis caught in it. Now, if you're all familiar with the praying mantis, they are one mean hombre. Well, the praying mantis was caught in the web, and this spider figured, ho, I'm going to have dinner here for a couple of days. But the praying mantis would have none of that. As the spider approached the praying mantis, trying to, I guess, inject its venom into it so that it would eventually paralyze it, the praying mantis released one of its arms from the web, very powerful, and kind of like poked the spider in between those multiple spider eyes, and the spider kind of like, you know, went back a step. And I remember, I'm giving you a 6 or 7 year old individual's perspective on this. So the spider's, I'm sure the spider was thinking something like, hey, what the hell are you doing? This is my home you're in. You better abide by my rules. Now just lay down and die. But the praying mantis said, no way. So anyway, while the spider was kind of thinking about why did this thing just poke me between my multiple eyes, the praying mantis released its other arm. And now it was ready to fight. It was still kind of locked in its location, but the spider approached it again. The praying mantis gave it another shot, and the spider went back, but this time the praying mantis attacked. And I guess it knew intuitively that the spider was going to inject it, so it used one of its arms to hold back the spider's area where its fangs were, and used its other arm to basically cut off one of the spider's legs. I think it was a three-jointed leg, and now it only had one joint. So I'm sure that the praying mantis and the spider, the leg was actually kind of like laying on the web. I'm sure the spider looked at that and said, what the hell just happened? That's not right. In the meantime, the praying mantis went to the other leg and did the same thing. Well, let me make a long story short here. Basically, the praying mantis killed the spider. And it took the praying mantis a little bit of time to get out of the web, but it did. And it went along its merry way. And all was well in the world of the praying mantis. Not quite that well in the world of the spider, but what are you going to do? Here's the point. The praying mantis was not in its natural environment, but it kind of made itself at home. Now, that's the reason I bring this up in a 5-Minute Motivator. How many of us, if we are not in our natural habitat or environment, feel out of place? Did you ever consider that maybe what we need to do is behave like the praying mantis and be a leader no matter where we are? Or at least be comfortable being a follower no matter where we are? The fact of the matter is that whether we think that this is a conducive or a non-conducive environment is simply perception. Why not perceive that everything is good? Why not believe that everything is going to happen correctly? And use the environment that you're in right now as a way of catapulting your goals. Bill Shockey, thanking you for attending another edition of the 5-Minute Motivator. Looking forward to seeing you in the next.